Hey guys, Menavtech here and welcome to the channel and to another video. So today Apple decided to prove me wrong and release iOS 13.4 public beta 5. I initially thought that iOS 13.4 public beta 4 would be the last public beta version we see of iOS 13.4 before it's officially released sometime this month. And for me, this update came in at around about 114 megabytes. If you look at the screen recording that I took before I updated, it's around 114 megabytes. And if you have an iPhone XS Max or an iPhone XS, it will come in at around 120 megabytes. So what has changed, or what are the new features with this iOS 13.4 public beta 5? If we go into settings and then go to general and then go to about, we can see that the software version number has changed. If you see there, it now has a 17E5255A. You can see that there isn't much change, but yeah, it's important to note that it has changed slightly. And then if we look at the modem firmware, we can see that nothing has changed. So pretty much everything has remained the same. In the previous beta version, we had an A at the end, and this time around, we still have an A at the end. So this is still the best and most stable version. I thought that we wouldn't see public beta 5 because public beta 4 was more or less stable. Some of the issues that I was facing with public beta 4 that are still present on public beta 5 are to do with Facebook and Instagram. So on Facebook, if you open up Facebook and then you try and upload a story, specifically like a video, and then you go into the trim section and then you try trimming the video, you see that Facebook crashes. And if you do this over and over again, even by restarting the phone, this will keep happening over and over again. And then also from time to time, Facebook won't open, and there's that delay that takes place. And so this is a bug that's still ongoing from public beta 4 to public beta 5. So just take note. And with Instagram, if you open Instagram and then sometimes you pretend to touch the top corner, this time around it worked, but yeah, this place around this area becomes unreceptive from time to time. I don't know if this is an issue with this public beta 5 or it's an issue with the iPhone X, as it has a screen record that I haven't yet had the time to take to Apple to address. But yeah, those are two of the main issues that I notice. And then performance is still the same. If you look at the benchmark scores that are there with this public beta 5, they are very much similar with what we had on public beta 4. The only difference is that depending on how many times you run the benchmark score, you might get slightly different scores. And so this is expected, and this is what usually happens. So if you run your benchmark scores quite a number of times, you will see that, you know, you might get a slight difference or variation in the benchmark scores, but this is expected, and slight variations are always common when you do a benchmark score. So when it comes to performance, it's more or less the same. And then when it comes to battery performance, you can see that nothing has really changed this time around. My battery percentage is still more or less the same, and also my optimization of the battery is more or less the same. And as you can see, the screen of on time hasn't changed really much. So when it comes to battery performance, it's still the same as public beta 4. Some iPhone XS Max are reporting slight better usage, but for iPhone X users, it's more or less the same. And then let's go into the part or section of what's new with this iOS 13.4 public beta 5. So I tried looking onto the Apple website and I actually didn't come up with anything new. And the features we basically had on iOS 13.4 public beta 4 are still more or less the same as what we have on public beta 5. The only difference that I was able to notice is if you go into Find My iPhone and then you open the Me section right here on the bottom, and then you expand it a little bit, you get a tab that comes up from time to time here that's a blank tab. Let me close this again and see if it comes an invisible tab. This time around, the invisible tab didn't show up. So there's an invisible tab that shows up here from time to time. And some iPhone users actually perceive that this is something that will have to do with AirTag, a new feature that will be coming to the iPhone. So keep that in mind as you use iOS 13.4 public beta 5. So basically nothing much has changed, and that's more or less it for me when it comes to iOS 13.4 public beta 5. Apple this time around seems to be more focused on fixing bugs and improving stability. However, as you can see, we still have some issues that are pending, and this might mean that we might see a public beta 6 and the developers beta 6. So just keep that in mind. As for the release date, we expect iOS 13.4 to officially be released at the end of this month. As you might know by now, the Apple event that was scheduled to be held at the end of this month has been cancelled due to the viruses going around in the world. So Apple might just do an online release and review of the products that were expected to be released at the end of March. So just keep that in mind. And yeah, that's it for me for now. I'm Half Man Half Tech, and thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe down below and stay tuned for the next one. Peace.